Well, I've done a lot of things for the show, but I gotta tell you, I've never before tried to sword fight. And I'm with the perfect person. He's the owner and head instructor here at Ottawa Swordplay, Craig Shackleton. Good morning.
Good morning.
How long have you been sword fighting?
I started sword fighting in 1997 when I lived in New Zealand. I joined up with a group there. Now, at that point, we were just sort of banging together swords and shields and doing stuff that kind of worked.
Yeah.
But when I moved back to Ottawa in 2000, I opened up Ottawa Swordplay, and we've been doing research and training actual historical techniques ever since.
So what I find interesting is that it's not just banging swords and poking each other. There's actually quite a lot of technique behind it.
Absolutely. Sword fighting in the Middle Ages was a very sophisticated martial art. There was a thorough system. And in fact, just like today, there's multiple martial arts, there were different systems. So I particularly teach a system from Germany that was developed by a sword master named Johannes Lichtenauer, who lived at the end of the 14th century. And his system was used for over 200 years, and we have dozens of manuscripts explaining how they taught and how the techniques work. So that's
okay.
What I work from.
So before I get you to show me the basics, something that I would learn in the beginner class, what have you suited me up in here today?
So what you're wearing right now is a set of 14th century style armor, although the helmet's a little bit earlier period. This is an 11th century Viking helmet, actually. But the armor is called a coat of plates, and it's all steel plates underneath the leather. And then it's over top of a mail shirt. And this was a very common style of armor in the 14th century when they were getting to add more protection than just the mail, which is what they had used before that.
And mail is what we most commonly hear
called chain
referred
mail.
To as chainmail.
Absolutely. Yeah, that's a sort of a change in terminology. Some historians will get very upset if you say chainmail. So I always try and say mail, although I won't give anybody trouble for saying chainmail in my classes.
Okay, and the description of mail is?
It is armor that is made of thousands of rings that are interlocked together to make a closed protective coat.
Okay, and what's neat is that, well, I mean, these aren't actual 11th century helmets and 15th century mail, because it's quite rare to find intact pieces.
That's
right.
There are artifacts, of course. Most of them are museums. Some of them are private collections, but they're extremely expensive, and I wouldn't want to use them, of course, because I'd be destroying something valuable. And they would have deteriorated to the point that they weren't very useful. So this is all modern made. The mail is actually made by a machine, and that particular one is designed as shark armor for scuba divers who dive with sharks. The helmet I actually made, that's one of the few pieces that I made years ago. And then the coat of plates was made by a modern armorer down in the States.
Okay. All right, so where would I start if I was coming to a class for the first time?
All right, so we usually start with the longsword, which is a sword for two hands, which is what we've got. Now, these ones are foam, and you want to hold your right hand by the crossguard like you've got, and your left hand down by the pommel, which gives you lots of leverage.
Okay.
And then you want to stand with your left foot forward and your sword at your shoulder like this. And this is our starting position. Now, we're really close to each other. Normally, we actually start fairly far apart like this. And our first attack is a diagonal cut that then, once you've got to here, you're going to just step in and stab me in the face. But of course, you're going to stop just short of actually stabbing me since I'm not wearing a mask.
Good thing you started me with the foam one.
Yes, absolutely.
Okay, let's
That's
try
why.
It once more.
All right, so the sword comes in first, and then you step in behind it. So even though it looks like it's a cut, it's actually a stab to the face. Now, the counter to this technique is actually identical to the technique. If I do that first strike, if you now do the cut, your sword comes in, pushes my sword out of the way, and you're aimed at my face, so you would stab me in the face.
Okay, my first taste of a sword play here with Ottawa Swordplay. We will continue to spend the morning with them here at 1000 Brookfield Drive. That's all coming up later in the show.